And welcome back. This is the RPG Chick. Welcome back to Let's Play Torment, Tides of Numenera. We made it through the nethermost cavity last time. It was a little harrowing adventure. We are in now the heart interior, and there's only one thing to interact with.
All right.
Ahead, you see a mass of bloom tongues, bigger than any you have encountered thus far. They wave gently, as if beckoning you forward. Your companions hesitate, looking to you. Okay, we have questions we can ask of all three. And then we can tell them we need their help. Do you have any insight, Calistes? I'm usually one for experimentation, but this? She looks at you, her face ashen. There is no telling what it will demand of you, child. Look at me and tell me if you'd want this fate. Yours could well be worse. What fate? She turns again to face the wriggling mass. Know what you are willing to sacrifice. That is my advice to you. She thinks, how many of my sisters would I give for myself? I dare not even think that way. How should I approach this, Tybeer? You're asking me? I didn't want to come here in the first place. He wipes his forehead, his easy smile gone. Be smart, lass. You know what you came for. Don't accept any less, and don't give any more than what it's worth. That's all I've got. He thinks, I should have stayed in Sagas. Nothing's worth this risk. None of them want to come with me. Is it fair for them, for me to have them come with us? But would we survive if they don't? What are you thinking, Aretas? Thinking? Nothing. A broad smile splits his face. But this is the greatest adventure a hero has ever invented. Advented? Isn't it? Will you go with me, Aretas? Are you kidding? I was going to ask you to follow me. Yes, let's attack this beast in its wiggly bits. Okay. Now, yeah. He reveres us, so he's going without question. The other two like us. I'll need your help in there, Calistige. I don't doubt that, but you will have to do without it, dear. This is well beyond anything even I am equipped to handle. If you insist on facing that thing, you must do it alone. Persuasion? Think of what you can learn. How many people have touched the very heart of the bloom? Well, how much do we need her? 100%. She frowns. I have thought of that. Not a single one of my sisters wishes to go. Perhaps this time, it must be me. She nods, her chin resolute. Very well, I will join you. Come with me, Tybeer. I mean, why come all the way down here and then not advance, right? He raises his hands in front of him, palms out. Oh no, I've followed you everywhere so far, but here's where I draw the line. You're the cleverest man I know. If anyone can help me outsmart this thing, it's you. I'm using up all my intelligence. He blinks, taken aback. I say, I have taught you a thing or two, haven't I? But I don't know if we can outsmart it, but I'll help you just for that bit of blandishment. It was well done. All right, let's do this. Wait, I need to restore my intellect. Before you looms a twisted mass of tubes, arteries, roots, and tongues, heaving and pulsing in the murky light. The flesh glimmers with foul shades of purple and black, pocked with pustules and necrosis. Bloom whispers gather, swarming all over you like flies, buzzing and chittering and hissing, millions of them. All the voices that comprise the bloom's mind are converging in this one place. As you step closer, bloom tongues surround you, drawing you into a wet, nauseating embrace. Though they seem solid and corporeal, they somehow pass through your flesh, thrusting into your head, your limbs, and your guts, igniting prickly, hot-cold sensations all over your body. Okay, now I feel bad for having them come with us. A multitude of bloom voices hiss and babble with rage. You cannot understand their words, but their meaning is clear. You don't belong here. The voices invade your mind, sweeping aside your thoughts, establishing themselves within. Your companions groan beside you, trapped in the same embrace. Now, you know, we've seen so much of the inside of this creature. What the hell does this thing look like on the outside? I keep wondering. I'm not here to fight you. I'm looking for a man called Ishen. I think you have him. Try to pull the tongues out of your body. Slash at the heart with a transdimensional scalpel. Rip one of the bloom tongues out of the heart. Or resist the bloom's voices. Or don't resist. Okay. I'm not here to fight you. I'm looking for a man called Ishen, and I think you have him. Indigo tide, right? Tiny amount. The voices don't seem to understand, or if they do, they ignore your words. More and more of them pour into your mind, chittering and whispering and shrieking. You can feel them overwhelming your conscious mind, even your sense of self. Try to form an image of Ishen in your mind, right? It's like we can... They're in our mind, right? So we can communicate with them that way? You focus on the goal that brought you here. The abducted scholar, Ishen. Or maybe this helps me, actually. Even as you think of him, an image begins to form in your head. A bald head, a beard, strange markings on the body, as if you somehow know this man. Or perhaps your sire did. I say definitely. The bloom's voices go quiet, pausing in their unrelenting assault upon your mind. They know Ishen, too. And now they also know why you're here. Your respite is all too brief. A few blessed seconds of silence, and then the wild cacophony returns, and the assault upon your mind continues. Alright, try to pull the tongues out of your body. Probably won't work. You grasp at the fat, wriggling bloom tongues and manage to get a grip on one. Then you pull with all your might. White, hot pain blossoms at the point where your tongue... where the tongue has burrowed into your flesh and surges through you, so intense that you nearly pass out. It's no use. The tongues are a part of you now, and you are bound to the bloom's throbbing heart. Yeah, I'm gonna use the transdimensional scalpel. 85%. Your movements are constrained by the bloom tongues, but you manage to get a grasp on the scalpel and drive it into the pulsing mass of tubes and arteries. It did not like that. Well, I tried to be nice, you know. The only thing else I can do is rip and resist. Well, I guess resist. But I'm kind of running low on intellect. The voices in your head scream, millions of them at once. The whole bloom shakes and groans. Foul brown ichor sprays from the wound, splattering your face. All around you the bloom tongues sag, and their grip on you weakens. The voices seem more cautious now. Some carry notes of fear. Again? I notice my stats aren't going down at all. You lunge swiftly at the heart, slashing open a fat, fleshy artery. Stinking yellow bile explodes in all directions, my god, soaking your clothes and hair. The heart jerks from side to side, and the bloom voices unleash a deafening scream, their pain and rage unmistakable. In the next moment, the voices are gone from your mind. The bloom tongues release your body, and foul, tentacled things are up from the floor. Yep. Corpuscular maws. Alright, let's do the hook. Because I don't want to move.
Making a dent over here.
Well, no, we just pulled it. That doesn't do much. Attack. Oh, he moved. what does he have? I haven't checked out his ciphers. Heals some stuff. Changing tool. Alright. I guess this isn't something that we use, it just, yeah, automatically iron. Alright, I'm gonna use this then.
Trouble coming your way.
I don't remember saying any of that stuff before.
Not making a dent over here.
Oh, you will when you attack. Hopefully. Okay, what does she have again? She is full. Heal 30 points of health. Refills all stat pools. I should give that to the last cast-off. Wait, aren't I on the last cast-off? I am on the last cast-off. Trying to look at Calistes. Drop something. They don't hold anything, so... Yeah. Just attack. What? Let me see. On all enemies before you. Or a target says all in small area. Makes me think allies as well. We've got two, so just gonna... Mind control this one? Well, this is me going. Right. Oh, for some reason, why did I think it was Calistes' turn? No wonder I was on my own profile. Whatever the hell you call it. Yeah, it's mind control.
You've already lost.
Okay. I'm done there, thank you.
Let's go.
Now here's Calistes. You know, for some reason... Yeah, that's right, I have Maelstrom. It was... Formerly Calistes had only one of them. Let's go.
Come, taste your death.
I love when she says stuff like that. I want her over there.
Don't.
Keep moving her around and crap. Of human capacity. Yeah, this is it. Oh, it's Tiber. He has a lot more speed than might right now, so sucker punch.
I feel better.
I want him up here. I think that thing's mind control. Not sure. In any case, there's one left, at least right now. It didn't attack at all. Of course, there's nothing for it to attack. Oh well.
What do you think of this?
Yep. Didn't do much. Yeah, I'll keep her there. Out of range. Timer, how about your hook thing? Oh no, among Calistes. What? I keep getting screwed up like that. Out of range, but how about for flash?
For me.
Maybe not.
It is done.
Not making a dent over here.
You dented it. Okay, so we mess with it again.
Let's go.
That's you. Everyone together. Thank you. We need... She needs intellect really badly. So take this thing. Oh, that's for health and intellect plus one. So no, don't take that. Refills all stat pools. Should I use it? Or should I use these? In order to get her to full... Yeah, I would have to use... four of those things. How many of them do I have? I have more than enough. That's my primary thing. I think we're going to need that for the battle ahead. Somehow I don't think we're going to have a chance to sleep.
Here, now!
Here, now.
Yes?
Thank you very much. 18. Out of 23. Calistes need some, really.
Yes, child.
I'll give her one.
Here, now.
The little one for me, okay. So 7 out of 15, we could use some... 5 fleet foot moss. This is for might. Got all this crap we have to sell. We have this Exuvia, which is not as good as what we have. 3 armor, 4 resistance. Wait, this is... yeah, it's body. 4 and 6. And this is 3 and 4, yeah. That's why we're wearing this and not this. Even though I like the intellect boost, but eh, what can you do? We have refined fleet foot moss. which is this glowing one. We don't have regular. Alright, so it's 6 points of speed.
Yeah.
And everyone else is pretty much good with speed. Tiber could use a little might. And Calisthes can only have a little might. Lutriated Force. We have 3 regular ones.
Yes, try.
So I'm gonna use the small ones. Who else? Tiber? 7. That's speed. Yeah, Tiber. This is hyper.
Yeah.
All right, so we're pretty much okay now, more or less. Alright guys, I want to make sure we're good. I'm going to save now and continue. One LP, 125. Checking to make sure it's there. Have it. Taking a long time to load up, maybe because I got so many. Okay, now.
Let's go.
Now can we go through? You step back into the blue tongue's embrace. They are cautious now, fearful perhaps, and it takes a few moments before they embrace you again. The bloom whispers return, but they're distant, wary, as if reluctant to draw your anger. Infiltrate the bloom's mind. Slowly, carefully, you extend your thoughts into the tubes and conduits of the heart, gently testing your ability to contract the muscle here or widen an artery there. You can hear the bloom voices all around you, but they don't seem alarmed. Either they don't sense you at all, or they don't perceive your intrusion as a threat. As you explore the limits of your new perceptions, you begin to understand the heart's composition. The fleshy nodules that serve as sensory organs, the tubes and arteries to feed the intelligence that dwells there, or here rather, the roots of innumerable whispering minds that descend to this spot from every corner of the bloom, tangling together to join their forces into a mad, chaotic union. We can search the thoughts for the abducted scholar Ishen, try to control the sensory organs, try to control the arteries, examine the bloom's memories. Tempting. Observe the heart as a biological system and watch for patterns. Observe the bloom voices and try to understand what they are. Alright, we'll do that. Bloom voices. You attend closely to the innumerable voices, chirping and whispering in the darkness of the bloom's mind. Your general impression is of many minds, many intelligences, that are part of a shifting whole, but you cannot be sure of anything beyond that. Observe the heart as a biological system and watch for patterns. For a time you listen carefully to the booming pulse of the heart and observe its movements, but it teaches you little more than you already know. Fluids are pumped here from elsewhere in the bloom, and they seem to feed the many-voiced intelligence that resides in the heart. A deeper understanding of this process is beyond you. Examine the bloom's memories. Floating unnoticed among the bloom's innumerable voices, you allow yourself to drift deeper into its mind. As the voices whisper amongst themselves, you begin to see brief images, to hear sounds, and feel hunger or satiation. These are its memories of the past. Screams echo in your ears, and as men and women are pulled into maws, their thoughts and personalities devoured, or simply altered, scrambled, changed into monstrous forms. You see limbs torn from bodies by eager bloom tongues, eyes plucked out so that tendrils can slide gently into their sockets to reach the brains.
Ugh.
For a moment, you see Grisler, the bloom guide, trapped in the embrace of a maw, and you can taste the raw flesh of his legs as the maw tears them off and devours them. You know, in that moment, that the bloom will eat of him again, and again, reveling in the taste of his undying faith that it will provide for him, a faith that is so ill-founded. And everywhere, you see and hear the Memovira, flashes of her early days, gathering followers to overthrow the old Memovira while publicly pledging her loyalty to him, her rebellion against him, as she slaughtered his people and dragged him down to the heart, binding him so that the tongues could feed upon him slowly, and all the years of her ruthless rule. In all that time she has never changed. Her face is the same now as it was when the bloom first saw her. Drift even deeper into the bloom's memories. All around you, Blue Tide, there's a tiny amount, whispers and chitters yield to more alien sounds, clicks and gurgles and dissonant tones. The memories change with them. Monsters stalk the corridors of the bloom, gelatinous hulks with flickering letters and numbers writhing beneath their skin, multi-limbed machines with legs that skitter through 100 dimensions at once, godlings formed from city-killing detonations with voices of fire and smoke and screams. Flashing before your eyes are all the worlds the bloom has seen, in their hundreds of thousands. You can sense the city creature crawling across time and dimensions since the universe was young, perhaps longer, its voices changing, its flesh adapting, its senses changing. Your mind begins to hurt. We permanently gain 2 intellect. Sorry, reading ahead. Permanent intellect. Maximum is now 25. Nice. And I still have that thing I can take, that candy Pez thing. Your mind continues to hurt, barely able to comprehend the sensory impressions that are contained within the most distant memories. Fighting the urge to scream, you disengage at last, allowing yourself to drift slowly back to the surface of the bloom's mind. And yet, even with that brief exposure, your senses have broadened, and you are better able to comprehend the impossible. Not even your sire dared to gaze so deep into an alien mind. Well, we could try these things, but we really want to find Ishen. So search the bloom's thoughts for the abducted scholar Ishen. 100% every time, I don't want to fail on this. While your thoughts are joined to the bloom's, you can almost understand its voices. A whisper will spark a fleeting image in your mind's eye. A hiss will elicit a flash of anger or desire or some alien emotion that you can't even comprehend. As you listen and watch, you see occasional images of a vague human figure. When you focus on them, try to hold them still, you see an isolated pocket of flesh, a cyst filled with thick black juices, in which the man floats, curled up like a fetus. The cyst is wrapped carefully in fleshy tendrils and knotted muscles, watched closely by tiny chittering minds that were spawned for exactly this purpose. Try to gain control over the fibers and muscles that guard Ishen. Come on, do a critical so I can get my stat pools restored. Yes! It heard me. So I'm still at 13 intelligence. Moving slowly and cautiously, you follow the faint whispers of the tiny chittering minds that watch over Ishen. They're not far from the heart, centered around a foul little cyst, just as you suspected. When they sense your approach, they squeal in alarm, but you overwhelm and silence them. You sense the remains of a transdimensional rift in the cyst, probably the same rift that the bloom used to capture Ishen in the first place. It should be possible to reopen the rift and set him free, but the bloom will know when you do. Does doing one of these things stop it from knowing? Okay. If I try to take control of the sensory organs around the heart, maybe that will stop it from sensing, so it won't know. So I'm guessing. Quietly, cautiously, you extend your consciousness into the bloated little sacs that quiver on the surface of the heart and within its many conduits. If you wished, you could put them into a sort of slumber that would make it harder for the bloom to sense your presence. Yes. Put all the sensory organs around the heart to sleep. All over the heart, the blubbery nodules slowly deflate, sinking into torpor. To your relief, the bloom makes no sound of alarm. We don't have a lot of intellect left, but what does this do? I have to know. Try to take control of the arteries that lead into the heart? Taking great care to avoid detection, you slip your thoughts into the tubes and arteries, assuming control of them. These fluids feed the intelligences that coalesce here. If you chose to do so, you could contract all the arteries at once, depriving them of energy. Huh. Would that... I'm thinking that might help him even more in setting him free without being detected, so let's try it. You gradually constrict the arteries, halting the flow of fluid to the heart. Something burbles irritably within the heart, like indigestion on a grand scale. Bloom voices chitter listlessly, but they don't seem to notice what has happened. Probably because you already deadened the heart's sensory organs. Cool. That we did it in that order. Reopen the transdimensional rift in Ishen's prison and set him free. You whisper slowly to the rift, and it begins to take shape again. Bloom voices shriek in alarm, but with the arteries constricted and the heart's sensory organs deadened, the bloom can do nothing to stop you. Sweet.
I'm ready to learn something new.
Nice. Is that him? You feel Ishen vanish from the foul little cyst. In the same moment, the air in the heart chamber ripples. A transdimensional rift tears itself into being, and a human figure topples out, dripping black juices, coughing and gagging, vomiting on the floor. And we gain 100 XP. Maybe we can sleep soon? Because, man, I just used so many of I forget what they're called, that give you intelligence back. And now I'm down to 7 out of 25. You recognize the man at once. It's Mazov, the cast-off artificer you met in Zirian Daywalker's Mere. Your first thought is that the bloom has somehow released the wrong man, but no. The Memovira deceived you. Ishen is Mazov. For the moment, Mazov is recovering from his ordeal, barely aware of his surroundings. He hasn't even seen you yet.